Okay, hello guys, we meet again with Ambob with another phone to be rooted. This time we have a Xiaomi phone. Okay, it's Redmi 4A. Our record name is Rolex, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, this phone is already unlocked and it has a custom ROM. Okay, so our job is to install the stock ROM into this phone and root it again using the latest messages. Okay. As usual, we go to the settings. Okay. Setting 4A. Okay. Enable the version number. I think it's already been activated. Okay. And now I want to turn on the USB debugging here. Okay. And plug in the USB camera. Okay. Now we're gonna flash the ROM. Okay. So I will open this Windows Explorer and trying to find the stock ROM. Okay. This is Redmi 5A Rolex. Okay. This is the stock. I want to use the Nugget. There is also the Marshmallow and Android Elf and the U10, but I want to use the U9 and Android Nugget because I think it is the best. Kind of lagging using the U10. Okay. Is extracted in here. Okay. Rolex. Okay. Extracted in here. And we're gonna open the command prompt. Okay. So type ADB space reboot space bootloader to go to the password. Okay. Oh, it seems fail. I don't know why, but we gonna force this phone to go to the password by pressing the volume down and power button at this time. Right? Okay. Okay. Here we go. Just put the phone in there. Wait for the file to be extracted. Okay, while we are on the passport, I want to make sure type of this phone. Okay, passport space get far space all. Okay, this is Rolex Redmi 4A. Okay, we're done. We're closing this pen drive. Going to the folder. Okay, as usual, I like to using PowerShell for flashing. So select the blank spot in the folder. Right click and shift button, and click the PowerShell. Okay, so we'll type in flash and hit the tab button for autocomplete. Okay, just press enter. Okay, we'll wait for a couple of minutes.
Okay.
So we're done pressing this this stop ROM, okay? We just need to close this windows and this one also. Now it usually don't boot into the fast boot. It's strange, but it's okay, we will try it. Okay, open the Explorer again in here. So I will try to find the TWRP, okay? This time I will try, I want to use this Red Wolf custom recovery, okay? So we're gonna open this command prompt and type it fastboot fast recovery, fastboot space fast fast recovery, and drag this recovery into the command prompt and press enter. Okay. After that, one more command, fastboot space boot space drag this file again. Okay. Now we are in the custom recovery. I want this one to tell you it's free. You can use any recovery, custom recovery, such as the Red Wolf, Orange, TWRP, whatever. This is my favorite for this one. Okay. So we're in the custom recovery. So as usual, keep brief only, select wipe, and select format data. We will type yes and hit the enter button here. Okay. And hit the home button again, select reboot and select recovery. Okay. This Magis 21.2, copy to the paste it to the internal. Okay, and after that I want to backup the images for questions. Okay, so backup and select this up here, level compression to make small size, and go to the first step. Yes, and check all of the option, except the boot and the FS. There's four questions. Okay. Okay, we're done backing up the boot. So hit the home button again. Install and select the Magis zip file. I don't want to force MD5, so I'll uncheck it. After that, I'll swipe it. Okay. Okay, we're done installing the Magis, so we just need to hit the reboot system here and wait for another couple of minutes. Okay. Then it takes longer time than you 10 or 11, but the ROM is more faster and light for this processor. It's according to me, I don't know about you. Okay, we hear the click sound and it sound that make us happy because we know that one is booted to the screen. Okay, let's click next. Okay, I want to use the English. Location, I'm in Indonesia. Where is it? Okay, skip this one, skip, set as new. It seems that this phone doesn't have a data connection, so we're going to hit the back button and connect it to the Wi-Fi. Connect it. Connection and we give password to the Wi-Fi. Okay, same as before, just next. Okay, we'll wait. Skip the email. Skip the send data. All set. You don't have to follow what I'm doing in this wizard, Android wizard. You just can click next. Okay, seems that it's already done. So now we're on the Android screen. Okay, I want to go to the settings, about one, and make sure that auto update is turned off. So I go to system update. But now these three button here. Click auto update and disable it. Go back, give me version 5 times, go back again. I want to enable the notification here, lock screen, okay, and go to the developer option. Okay, go disable it again. Okay. There is a update notification in here, so I will just press this one and uncheck all of it. After reboot, it will disappear, but only appear when you connect to the Wi-Fi. And then USB charging, I want to transfer file. Okay, so we're gonna copy two file, the Magis Manager. Okay, open under Windows Explorer. Copy it to the download folder. Okay, I'll paste it here, and I want to copy the root checker. Okay, now we have two apps. screen, go back to the pawn. Okay, there is already match manager in here, but it's in the robot icon, so I want to remove it. Yes, remove file, uninstall it, and open the file manager here. Okay, just allow it, agree, click in here. You also can click in here. Click the image manager. It will ask for unknown source, so we click setting and enable the unknown source and hit back. Okay, we will install two of these apps. Install this root checker. Okay, we have two apps in here that I've already installed. So first thing, we open the Magisk Manager. Okay, as usual, it requires additional setup, so we just click OK and it usually will download the Magisk. You can see it. After that, it will reboot in 5 seconds. Okay, so just wait for it. Now it's done, it will reboot in 5 seconds. So just put the pawn down, wait for the pawn to reboot it. Okay, we're back on the home screen. So we want to check if the Magisk is already done installing the update. Okay, we open the Magisk again, and usually for the first time it will force cross. Usually, I don't know about this time. And you want to make sure that you have an internet connection. Okay. And open it again. Okay, it takes longer time than usual. Let's wait for it. Problem in here, I don't know. Let's just open the root checker. Is it the Magisk alive or not? Okay, well, the checker is asking for permission, so we grant it. So basically the Magisk is already running, but we cannot open it. If there is problem, okay. As usual, okay, we can see it that this Magisk is already installed. Version is 21.2 and the latest is 21.2 also. Okay, after this, you can activate the Hide Magisk and repack the Magisk Manager. Or if you want to install module, you can check in my other video. Okay. Can see it also, this one is successfully deleted. Okay, thank you for all. I hope this tutorial is helpful for you. Okay, if you don't mind, I really appreciate it if you click this subscribe button. If you like Rooting Pawn, with subscribe my channel, you will receive a notification if there is a new video. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day. Assalamualaikum.